win it 129-118. Jokic with 38 points, 18 rebounds. Anthony Davis gave it a good run this afternoon.
It sucks. It sucks telling these guys every game, proud of you, good effort, we lost. And it's just disappointing to come in and, you know, just keep saying we fell short.
God in my cells, that's my celly. Made in the image of God, that's a selfie.
Keyshawn, J. Will, Max, ESPN, so many Sirius XM Channel 80.
Post my bell.
Lakers at full strength on Friday. AD, LeBron, and Russ still lost.
I'm just laughing because yesterday on the call, Key started going in on the Lakers. And I'm like, Key, you guys are up by like 15 right now on the Nuggets. It was like middle of the second. And Key's like, just give it another 60 minutes.
Yeah.
Just give it. His words verbatim. And sure enough, it happened again.
I mean, yeah, they sorry though, man. It ain't even nothing.
You knew that though.
How did I know that?
Life jacket
don't
on?
Nobody. How you going to know that? Jay, there's no way of knowing that they sorry. You got.
Key, you still got the life jacket on the back of the boat? You still holding
on? You're going to have to give me the numbers now because I stopped paying attention to the numbers. I stopped adding it up and when could they, if they could, what if. I just gave up, right? I mean, that's just the reality of it. But we can also ask Magic Johnson, who'll be joining us at 9 a.m. Eastern on ESPN Radio, what he thinks about the Los Angeles Lakers. That's for sure.
I'm sure he's not going to be happy at the moment after their sixth straight loss. By the way, Jokic. And by the way, I agree. Like, it was, even when it was close in the third quarter, I'm like, Lakers might get this.
No.
Jokic, 38-18-6. As he, you know, listen, he's the favorite at this moment to win his second consecutive back-to-back MVP. Going to be back-to-back MVP most likely. And it's so interesting to me what's going on in the MVP race. Like, Giannis blocked Embiid, literally blocked Embiid and outplayed him and won the game. And it's like, did he just block Embiid from the MVP? And now give it to Jokic? No, Giannis maybe. Except Luka just outplayed Giannis and ended his MVP chances on Sunday. It looks like, did he? Monday morning roundup brought to you by AutoZone. Get in the zone, AutoZone. But it comes down to, at this moment, if you had to handicap it, because like all these games down the stretch, and Jay, you pointed out, they're like highlight games. This dude versus that dude. Giannis went out and got pelts on the wall. KD, Embiid, you know. Uh-oh, Luka got him. Can't afford to do that right now when it's this close, and especially if you're considered the guy in third place. Embiid, for a lot of the year, I think, was considered the front runner.
He dropped 44 in the Cavs last night.
Yeah. A lot of the year, I think, he was considered the front runner. Seemed to. So, but anyway, he said this yesterday. If it happens, great, when it comes to the MVP. If it doesn't, I don't know what I have to do. I feel like they hate me. I feel like the standard for guys in Philly is, or for me is, different than everyone else. I mean.
Man, don't blow that horn, man. Y'all need to stop.
Get out of here, Yates.
I mean, to me, that's a pretty transparent attempt to pander to the Philly audience, right?
Yeah, but
it's us against the world.
Man, please. How you going to be us against the world? You ain't had nobody. The Philadelphia, the Sixers, who have they had since AI?
Yo,
that is worthy of an MVP.
Yeah.
Key,
yeah,
people do be hating on Philly, though.
Come on, man. They bring it on themselves with their behavior.
Knicks all day long, and
the market is horrible. The Knicks, by the way,
New York.
It's five times the size of
New York.
That don't mean nothing.
It's
talking about
New
the team that's the best
York.
Chance to
it
win.
Does not. It's New York. They will talk about the MLS team in New York before they will the Philadelphia 76ers.
So you're making the case,
Keith,
that
you
would just be hating on Philly sometimes.
It's not
the
hate,
Sixers
it's
get
New
plenty
York.
Of press.
Yes.
Where?
Sixers
where?
Get press commensurate with the size
Simmons?
Of their market and how good they are.
Lies.
There you
and
get
then,
him,
and then think about it. Like I said, man, they talked about Dr. J. They talked about Moses. They talked about Barkley. Yeah. They talked about, who else am I? Dr. J.
And AI.
Then there was nobody else to talk about. Then they talked about AI. They gave him his MVP and his love. And then there was nothing until Embiid.
Then
what do you want him to do?
Matumbo got
what,
love.
Wait, Barkley had to leave Philly to win an MVP, Key. You know that, right?
But
Barkley had to leave Philly to win an MVP.
He was a big, famous star.
He had to leave Philadelphia to win an MVP.
Because they were challenging for titles.
But was he an MVP, truly an MVP, at that time in Philly?
He wasn't even at that time in Phoenix.
Yates, do you have something to say here, Yates?
Man, the national media has been killing the city of Philadelphia since I was a child. Yo, it's every time I turn around, it's, oh, they hate Santa Claus.
They what do?
It's
Santa Claus. Well, booty. Like,
Santa Claus not real. I don't understand why all the hate is.
What are you doing? Kids.
Yates, you're right.
What's wrong with this dude?
See, look, this is a Disney show, Yates. What are you doing?
Yates, what are you
doing? You're not wrong. Philly fans can get a bad rap at times, and I'll speak up when I see that, like, Ben Simmons, stop. That's not Philly being hard on Simmons. They took care of him, all this kind of stuff. I'll be straight up, but the idea that Embiid, like, here's what you got to do, Embiid, to win an MVP. You got to be the best, and you're one of the best.
Got to stay healthy.
You have not shown a real differentiation between you, Jokic, and Giannis.
But see, here's what I'm going to say. Jokic dropped 38 and 18, right, last night. The Lakers are a stat sheet right now, man. Come on.
Because they're a brand name, though, Keith.
But it's still, the Lakers right now, I hate to say it, but I might go drop 38 on them.
Agreed,
I
mean, the game was nationally televised. You know what happens?
I understand.
That's what I talk about. Like, for Giannis, the games that are nationally televised, it means something because the fans get a chance to see it. Like, Embiid had 44 in the Cavs. That's a great win, but nobody really saw it last night. And what are we doing? We're talking about Jokic dropping a double-double in the Lakers.
Hold on. The producers are all getting in on this. Yes, Evan.
No, I think that there is some stats and information to back up the idea that Charles Barkley, when he was in Philly, got flat out screwed out of the MVP, and it went to a guy in a different market. A guy we'll have on today. In 1990, Magic Johnson.
I gotta go.
In 1990, Magic Johnson averaged 22 points, 11 assists, 6 rebounds a game, shot 48% from the field. That same year, Barkley averaged 25 points, 11 rebounds, and shot 60% from the field. Both teams won their divisions, made the playoffs, and Magic Johnson won the MVP by 22 votes over Barkley. Barkley, you could make the argument that Barkley did not win the MVP because he was playing in Philadelphia this season. The Lakers won 10 more games, but they both won their divisions, and Barkley had better stats that year.
So the Lakers won 10 more games. How did the Lakers finish that year?
Both teams won their division.
No, how did they finish in the finals?
Well, it didn't matter. I mean, the MVP voting was...
No, I understand that, but what I'm getting at is, wouldn't you think that the voters was going to project that the Lakers was going to the finals and at the same time they was going to lean toward that?
Yes.
What do you mean?
Both teams got knocked out of the playoffs in the second round.
Thank you.
Hold on. Key is right.
They're projecting that.
If you watched that season, no one in the world thought Barkley, you'd rather have Barkley than Magic.
It's not about
Magic
you
was
rather,
like performing you, at genius level.
It's not about what you rather have. It's about who had the best regular season.
I get that, though, Jay. But when these people are doing these votes, and Evan would know, that they sometimes factor in things that may not have anything to do with the regular season. They're looking and saying, well, they're probably going to get to the championship. So why not just give them a little extra nugget? That's all I'm saying.
Wait, why would Evan know?
Well, I don't want to go into that.